A new study shows that diabetes is skyrocketing around the world.
The researchers say cases have quadrupled in the past 3 decades. The study is in The Lancet, and it finds 422 million adults have diabetes worldwide. The researchers found that low and middle income countries experience the biggest jumps in diabetes and that it is more common among men. Obesity is a main risk factor.
And exercise, really monitoring carbohydrate intake, eating less processed food, eliminating sugary drinks, that's really the key.
Diabetes is the 7th leading cause of death in the United States, killing about 70,000 Americans a year. Meanwhile, Hennepin County Medical Center has a new way of treating diabetes that might prevent amputation. I know, Susan-Elizabeth, you had a chance to check that out today. It sounds promising.
I really did. This is new technology. It's only being offered in one place in this state. And as you can imagine, if you're a patient mentally preparing for an amputation, this can be a game changer.
Ed Davis has photographed the world, leading a life of adventure and, as his son describes it, an addiction to Tootsie Rolls. But times haven't been so sweet as of late. Last month, he had all his toes amputated off his left foot.
I never see him, you know, curse his luck or you know, woe is me or poor me. It's always, well, how do we, you know, work with what we have and move forward?
I'm just a cog in the wheel.
His pioneering attitude landed him in the hyperbaric medicine area of HCMC. He has regular treatments in a chamber where it feels like he's 45 feet underwater.
We're able to get their oxygen levels up 10 times higher than you can under normal circumstances.
Ed's also enjoying some new unique technology. A dye injection flows through his legs in the dark. A camera shows where blood is flowing.
Yeah, it looks pretty good there, Ed.
And which parts can heal or which parts need amputation. Before, doctors just had to make an educated guess on what needed to go.
This hopefully equips us to have better outcomes for our patients. You know, what we're trying to do is save as much of their legs as we can, because the worst case scenario for these patients is that they end up with a debilitating amputation that leaves them wheelchair bound and dependent on other people.
That's Ed's hope for himself and his fellow patients.
You carry on normally.
Saving a limb, salvaging independence.
So the big goal for Ed is that even though his toes are gone, he can save the rest of his foot. We were able to see the blood flow in his foot today with this new device. And right now, it appears he is doing pretty well, healing up. Now, if you want to know more about this treatment, the center says just give them a call. They're open. They love to take more patients. We've got a link on WCCO.com. Frank.
Well, good. Hope it works and wish Ed well. I mean, it's such a huge change of life.
It really is. It's really a mental thing and physical thing too. So if they're saving people's limbs, great.
Good for them, for sure. Thanks.